Yeah, I think we are both coming back and wet bandits here.
Yeah, absolutely. Being a team that we've watched from afar.
And I mean, Jake on here as well is a really fantastic player. He is definitely growing throughout these games as well. Really 37 on a warm up, but that doesn't really mean too much.
Jake on 38 on warm up. That's no mean feat.
Looks like we will be going into the knife any second now. There we go. We will now be going into the knife. And both teams have decided to buy full knives. And actually, Team Andrex Soft all have vanilla knives.
Unbelievable. What is going on?
That is disgusting. Actually, most people in this server have basic knives.
Only T4 and Cammy with the old Krambit and Falchion.
Falchion. Nah, it's a Falchion. I don't like that knife, and it doesn't make sense with the fact that you can hold on your knife upside down. It's just stupid, I'm sorry. It's like, what? Well, I actually quite like the butt plug knives. Whatever they're called, I can't remember.
Shadow.
I don't know. I think they're much better than the Falchion, to be honest.
Monster's just going to be making a dash for it here. Like green bastards in the dark of Inferno.
He actually kills. I thought he was going to make that final kill as well, but no. Kiwa just has none of it.
It's not to be.
Brilliant. I wonder what side they're going to pick, actually. Oh, I don't imagine. Yeah, CT. And I did call it. I did say if they start on CT, they need to make a big push on this.
Yeah. So hoping for a 9-6 off if they want a chance to go into the next round.
Hello, Andy.
Hello.
But no, yeah, this is definitely going to be quite an interesting game. I wonder if it's going to go into overtime. We're actually going to see a bit of an unstandard setup here, 2 on A, which is going to be a bit of their downfall, actually, as it's going to be an A push.
Yeah, most of the T's moving up second bit now with the bombers as well. Mamet getting one kill into Philo, that's going to weaken the B defensive 3, and potentially a man could be rotating now, seeing that. However, they are going into ups. Hopefully the man in pit city's going to hear this, but now he's going to see it, and they're going to drop straight on his head. Take out one, which means JPOP, it can't find one straight away. Move on. Get that partner in. 4v3 retake situation, but the T's really need to get up to the site now. One still over on B.
Wow.
Goes down. Cammy with a massive 2k.
3k, that is absolutely beautiful from them. All headshots, if I'm not wrong in saying.
But Mamak just keeping that the CT over on B the whole time. He has no chance to help his teammates. There's nothing he can do. So that CT is going to find himself completely out of position, and he's just going to go for that save, keep that armor into the next round, see what he can do with it.
Kevlar save, absolutely brilliant. You still have the games where his father is that the other team are like, "What are you doing? Why are you saving?" He's like, "Saving the Kevlar." Like, well, he can't really do anything else. I mean, he still has like 1800. He has his armor. Easy upgrade. I mean, yeah, I think he should go for the armor upgrade and for pistols.
Mamak just securing that round for his team, really, just making sure that the last man couldn't do anything except stay on that site.
Yeah, I mean they started for that rotate, but as soon as he got that kill on Philly on Car, the rotate just stopped. Unfortunately, I'm pretty sure that's what saved them around. So yeah, Mamak being the MVP of that round. With Kami though, with those three headshots, was just ridiculous.
Yeah, just insane. Quick push knife.
No, don't do that. Don't throw that flame. Not worth it. Throw it into the corner. Go on.
He's just taking it slowly. They have lost a man now, so they're going to have to be a little bit careful.
Wow.
Jake on with a nice quick headshot onto T4, and that's going to make it a lot easier for the BTs here going into this round. They've recovered the Mac 10.
They've actually got it down, and Filio going massive for those two kills down mid. Absolutely beautiful. It's now a 1v5 situation, down to 54 HP. Takes down Filio.
Yeah, like I said, Matt definitely does favour the eco, but with JPath, no health, there's really not much he can do. But he's going to get taken down by City to close out the round.
And City doesn't actually rush forward to pick up that gun, which is a bit of a worrisome right there. Yeah, they still managed to pick up two SMGs from that round. Filio upgrading straight to the M4, deciding to just go with no armour, which I think was a bit of a mistake, to be honest.
Oh no, he's going to pick up the money towards the end. He's not going to go for the old Jimmy Neutron.
Be towards a slight bomb staying in spawn though.
Yeah, maybe just having a bit of a hug out in spawn, just seeing what's going on. They can't quite decide who's going to take the bomb. It appears. Looks like.
Perfect. Perfect play from Jaycan there. Jaycan, rather. Not Jaycan. Yeah.
Yeah, you're going to take down.
Wow.
Another really nice spray through the smoke to take down Plasma. That must have been. Lucky. Bomb now at the bottom. Banana really not much position of control. Cameron going to try and get that kill with the Galuni. He's going to secure that, but City in the back line's just taking down that make on the rotate. And Parfit. Nice headshot there. And it's a 1v4. Cammy going to try and claw back into this round, but it's unlikely with City behind him.
I've actually just been notified Team White Bandits actually have a bit of an issue with one of their players currently, Marmak. They're not actually playing very well together, but yeah. And yes, a little bit, I know you saw that, but it was Flusher. Have they held it for the pause? Yeah, they have. There you go. Wow, okay, it seems to be a bit of an issue going on. I'm not quite sure what's going on.
Seems he's left the team speak as well and is blocking in the spawn.
Wow. If he continues this on, then he will actually have to be banned from the JGL tournaments for future, because that is just not acceptable.
Nice guard in a link set, though.
Oh, yeah. All right, just let me give...
Really nice headshot there from Tifa onto City down mid.
They have actually asked for a pause. We can't do a stand-in, unfortunately, just due to the nature of Face It.
Really quite impressive, though, coming out from the TC to be able to claw this round back into a 2v2 situation, especially losing that player at the beginning. Whether they're going to be able to make this round into much more depends on this next frag from Plasmas. AD spam, and there we go. Plasmas is going to get the kill, so they're going to rush straight down that banana site. And only Cubit left now. I'm going to try and claw his way back into this round. Coming through CT spawn, he definitely has a chance with the cross not being smoked off, but with the MP9, not going to look too likely because he's got that range advantage and then his position.
And he does go for that as well, a bit of a weird play.
He's going to get one frag, so he's definitely got a chance into this round with the Plasmas being so low, but the flank is going in from deep. If he gets this frag, he definitely has a chance. No, he's going to go down, and that's going to close out the round.
Yeah, I mean, very well played from T4 as well. And no orbit, unfortunately, we can't do a stand-in. There's just no chance due to Face It's rules. They have paused to try and deal with what's going on here. They did team kill, but there is no fifth player that's going to be able to come in here. Just let me make them aware.
There you go. The chat really getting off here. Not really sure what to do.
Yeah, they'll know. Yeah, and unfortunately, this is a bit of a downturn, but they have still managed to pick up two rounds as the T side. And I mean, they've got quite a good economy here to be able to do a buy.
Yeah, it looks like they're just going to be leaving Malak in spawn. I think he may have just given up at this point. Yeah, interesting buy coming out from the CT tower. They're going to decide to force up, knowing that they're 5v4 to begin the round. I think this definitely messes with our predictions a little bit.
No, yeah, it's going to be changing the dynamics of it, rather. Ooh.
Came out to go this way. Unfortunately, I don't think we'll understand these circumstances. But the T's going to be gentle towards the banana area. The bomb's coming back from T spawn. And City's going to see that. He's going to see the bomb rotating back. So, probably going to rotate over to the B area. Looking to run into a stack here, other T's. But they're going to be pulling back, just slowing the round down a little bit. They've got the pick. So they can afford to just slow down their pace. They're going to have the man advantage, but as we know, one player is not there, so it's going to be just equal. Keeping that pressure up towards the banana at the top. Just trying to show presence, make sure that the CTs know they can't rotate off quite yet. But Sweet Lemon is going to get their one kill onto T4, going to open up the round completely. Give them man advantage once again. Frogs will be coming in now. Looks like it is going to be a full B execute. But they haven't spiked the cross, so this could really damage the push.
Definitely. And as this peak comes in, he takes down the first player. And getting the headshot on the second is going to make all the difference. Low HP gets taken down by it from City. Bomb's not going to go down.
On the bomb with the player still alive in the... It looks like they ran out of time there, but trying to pond the bomb with a player still alive in this site, really, yeah, not the best idea. And it's going to cost them.
Right, and we were actually getting kicked.
So, a bit of a quasi by coming out from the T's here. One AK and a few pistols upgraded and some armors. Just looking to do a little bit of economical damage, perhaps, or maybe even try and take this round, but pushing up Banana, getting it in control, going with a bit of a default, but T4's going to go down with the AK. That's the AK lost if they can't recover that, so that could be really detrimental to the push. Plasma's just going to have to try and edge forward, see if he can pick that AK back up, but it's looking unlikely. Jaycon's got the forward control.
Yeah, and Cammy there sustaining that damage as well is going to be quite detrimental there to that push.
Yeah, another nade going and just bringing Cammy a little further down. Sweet Lemon's making sure they can't steal that AK back. Holding that position, but Cammy's going to take him down. Half of another one. But looking a little bit better. It is a 3 versus 3 situation now. The T's have a bit of control. They could potentially go towards A now and have a 3 versus 1 situation with the player in pit beating Philo. Not seeing much action so far as they haven't really gone towards him much.
No, yeah, and I mean, if anyone's going to be able to hold a slide, I'd definitely say it would be him. And I mean, if the T's armed with 3 rifles now as well, it's going to be quite a strong position. But there is only 3 of them. 2 are quite low HP.
Yeah. So, I mean, he doesn't have the utility, perhaps. But he could definitely have a good fight.
Although, Filio's going to get walked straight into a nade and get taken down. That is actually going to lose the bomb site, and they're going to get the bomb plant as well. Unless Kiva can do something here. He actually gets the headshot. It's now a 1v2 situation with Plasma of 19 HP.
Kiva's low, so potentially if Plasma gets his first shot, he could have a good chance into this round with the other player flanking.
They need to make sure they bait this very well. And they do play it quite well. They know where he is, but no. But Jaycan is just having none of it with that defuse kit. It's easy to do. And just a quick update, Marmok is now banned for the next 30 days from the TS server, and he will be back, kicked off the server momentarily. But moving swiftly on there, I'm pretty sure Wet Bandits still have a chance with this if they pull off an Envious and just destroy them on the T side. But I mean, the CT side, 4 players, is going to be very difficult to pull off.
Absolutely, it will be a struggle, but there is potential for sure.
Oh, definitely, and they go into a 4-spy here. Quite good utilities, apart from on Cammy there, just with the smoke. But if anything, that smoke is going to make all the difference compared to just the flashbang.
Ooh. Yeah, once again, just pushing up Banana, see if they can get some control. Looks like Cammy's going to be taking the fight towards City and get that kill. And another one, Cammy, with a very quick double kill. Really quite impressive from him. Just securing that A long sight. There's still one man in pit. That's Philo, without the orb now, orb being put onto Sweet Lemons, interesting decision, but Cammy's not going to go for that A site, he's going to go for the flank, see if he can catch any PTs on the side. I'll be aware of this, looks like just focusing on that main Banana. So Cammy potentially could be getting in this really big flank here, the bomb sitting on a bay, so if they choose to rotate, they really will have something to go to. He looks like he's going to be getting in behind Sweet Lemons here. Philo goes down in pit, that's giving them the A site, and the rotation should be coming in here, it's just not. Cammy's going to be going for the knife, and he's going to get it.
Gets it.
Really nice play there from Cammy.
And he has that follow-up kill. Is that 4 kills he managed to grab there?
Yeah, that was a 4K. Really big work from
Cammy. I think he's been fueled a bit by Mamuk there. But no, that was beautiful.
Bringing out the fury.
Definitely has motivated them.
Really pulling his team through, and he's on there 10 frags, 5 frags above anyone else on the team.
Yeah, we are gonna. Frag 7s. Never talk shit about them. They're really good.
Yeah, armor on Jake on the cube, just going to be going for the Mag 7 hell armor. Really interesting buy, not sure if he could pay off, but he could be getting that one kill.
Go for a bit of Jimmy Neutron and meta play. Cuba, no, just getting taken straight down by Jay Paffert. Sorry about that. Paffert.
Take on, however, does get that one kill. T4 is not going to see the man now, so he's going to get taken down. Then she could go for the second one here. He recovers the weapon.
No, he gets Kobe'd.
Yeah, not much you can do about that. But they have been out of control of CTs, so they're going to be pushing down over there where the bomb's going. So, the right hit's going to be coming in towards B. Sweet Lemon's just going to be trying to hide behind the sandbag, see what he can do. They're not going to see him, they're not going to catch him, and they're getting absolutely mowed down. But Parfit turns around, gets a really good kill, but he's left on 13 health versus 5 on the Mag 7.
And that is a P250, he's got quite good range on it, a lot of damage in this punch, and I mean, Filio does have that large spread as well. Against 13 HP, he's going to have quite a good time. He doesn't have a kit though. Don't know if there's any kits on the floor for him to pick up.
With the player now towards A, he's going to have to really get his boots on to get over there and get that frag very quickly. If this is played correctly, then he really has very little chance going back into this round, especially without the kit or armor. So he could potentially just go for the save here. That would probably be the smart play.
Yeah, I mean, if he goes down banana, goes to try and pick up a weapon, he might end up a little bit stronger. Well, he does actually pick up the AK.
Maybe going for this retake.
Aims at him straight through the wall. That's hilarious. Them hacks like them hacks. But don't worry, guys. He is just lifting the mouse up a little bit too high whilst doing it.
If only he knew. He could potentially go for the exit here, though. Perfect going through mid.
No, doesn't need to.
Really nice 3k in the round there for Parfit, just securing that site for his team.
Yeah, and it really does seem that this map is not Filio's this map, because he's only on 3k's here, 3 kills. And the T's are now officially down to 4 man, and they really are pushing on it, saying, you know what, we don't need this guy, we're going to push on anyway. And luckily for them, he was their weakest player, as I'm showing the fact that he has left, but we'll see how it goes from here.
And Filio's really risky, but he's going to get taken out by Cammy. And the B site is theirs. I'm not quite sure why the stack was coming in there with no information, especially with the one player just standing in the smoke. Questionable decision, but it looks like they are going to try and come in for the retake. All the players on B are on the site. They haven't pushed off. They're very little control, so the retention rate for CTs is definitely high. Sweet Lemons goes down to Plasmas, reduces the chances a bit more. Jaycon and Construction goes down. There's two more players to deal with. Whether they're going to be able to get much done. Looks like they're just backing off, going for the exits perhaps. City maybe pushing forward. But T4 is going to be looking at the position and he's going to take him down. The last man now in Construction versus 4. Probably going to get the last hit and goes down to T4.
Yeah, he didn't actually manage to get that last kill, which I'm pretty disappointed to be honest. And the T's actually, none of them died.
Yeah, the T's now taking the advantage, 4-5 to them.
Look at that money as well, solid play from them.
Absolutely, really compensating for that lost player.
And I think they made the right decision here, is just go for the AKs, go for the smokes, execute it really well, which they have been doing. The flash is down mid as well.
In a really fast pace now coming out from the T's, just pushing into the positions in the need, getting those kills, and playing off them. They've smoked off the port side, so they can just push through. And with only one player to take down, and City watching the cross, he's not going to be able to do much now. They're down to 20 health. He does take down Jay Parfit, but potentially could get naded down here. No, he's too far away, so he's not going to get that. No free kill there for him.
Cuba being flashed on long. Don't know if he realises that Cammy's coming straight up to him here. He does manage to move away in time, but City's going to get exposed. No. Cuba following up on Cammy, which I think is a crucial kill for them, because now it's a 2v4 situation. They are moving back towards B as well for the bomb. And they do still have left. Smoke for passing over for CT.
Yeah, they've also got a 2v1 situation here as Jakin rotates off. So they have a lot of potential to get this site themselves. They are going to take that, so they have the site. Jake got through this smoke. Really nice shot on the people. Narrows the chances down. 30 seconds, they could get the bomb down still, but whether they're able to hold now is another question.
Wow.
Really nice shot there from Plasmas.
20 HP versus 55 AK versus AK. One shot is all it takes from either person. Well, to the head anyway.
He hasn't planted yet though, and he's only got 7 seconds left. He could definitely get caught out here. The city doesn't see him, but there he does. Get the kill.
That was a good flick back onto him as soon as he realized his mistake there. Yeah. If he picks up this AK, you have a little bit extra skill power from the skin.
Yeah, almost had a really nice round there from Plasmus, but just not quite enough. 5-5 now, scores tied. The T's are going to have to go for that buy still. So the economy has built up. Sweet lemons on the Pro 90. Just going to try and get those spray downs.
Yeah, and I mean, they're really, and Androx Soft are really going to want to push on this and make sure they don't lose any more rounds, because they need these rounds to push up against the Web Bandits on the T side.
Yeah, especially against four players. They really don't want to be losing this. Could be quite embarrassing.
And Jay Parfit actually opting in for the AWP, which will be an interesting play. We haven't seen any AWP play from them, if I remember correctly. So it'd be quite crucial for these picks. They didn't go for mid though, which is a bit of an interesting one. And we actually have Jaycon actually deciding to flame his own player there, Sweet Lemons, taking a bit of team damage. Managing to get 1.5 kills with her. That was very close.
Yeah, a bit of a fake coming out. Just throwing that Molotov in saying, no, don't worry, there's no one here, you don't have to worry about that. And a really nice fake smash coming out. Eventually another player could be rotating over in City, but no, he's going to hold strong.
It's now a 3-4 situation with the Plasmus down to 40 HP. But we've seen what he can do with that AK. Wow. T's very low on the HP, losing the advantage here. Clasping straight back at it.
Situation there. So, there's still a lot of potential here. Two CTs returning onto the B
20
side.
20 seconds. It's going to be very tight, but they are going to be going for the B execute here.
Yeah, if they can get one for everything, they're going to get a bomb carrier, but unless they get this one quickly, which they're not going to do, the bomb carrier gets dropped by Philo. And City just about catches the guy in the smoke. Almost, let's see. Fast, but he's going to take him down, and the last man, Jay Parfit, is going to go down.
And Jay Parfit's hopefully going to be able to pick up this AWP and upgrade. Yes, this is what we want to see.
Yeah, Philo moving up onto that AWP now. See what work he can get done. Taking over to the A side, maybe going for that pick onto middle. Yeah, feeling looks like he's going to be taking this to mid. See if he can get a pick. Yeah, there we go. He's onto Jay Parfit. He's going to be down. Maybe a little bit annoyed about that. I think it may have been his AWP as well.
Like we said, we wanted to see that AWP come out for Filio, and it really is just going to make the difference for him, I reckon. But we do actually have Cammy here doing the damage he can. Takes out City.
Really take that. As if they need any more disadvantages than Filo picking up that AWP and losing a player.
Wow. That flame is going to split them up, but no, Filio goes down. Plasma is picking up the kill. T4 on Cuba. Swag 7 left on short. He takes one down one.
Yeah, definitely very effective against those low health players. And Sweet Lemon is just going to sweep in and take it out on the last player. And maybe recover that AWP as well.
They do that.
Yeah. Jay Parfit's AWP used against Jay Parfit to pick Jay Parfit. Jay Parfit was not happy about that.
No, definitely not. And that was the crucial kill that they made. I mean, down straight down to three plays is very difficult to then push onto Inferno.
Yep, essentially, next round could be the last chance for the T's. Economy-wise, yeah, after this economic.
This is a very weird play from, again, from the CTs going mainly onto the B site. The Cammy walking straight into the flame there. He's going to be stuck there. He's going to just ride out. Straight down. Yeah, that was brutal.
Can you get a grenade headshot?
Yeah, you can. You can one shot someone with the grenade if you hit them in the head.
But would it come up as a headshot? Would it show a headshot?
If they have low enough health, then I don't know. I think you can, because you can do it with Molotovs and flashes, I think, and smokes. I'm pretty sure you can. I actually have T4 here, proving that the Deagle is a worthwhile buy.
Not worthwhile enough. I think going to the spy next round now. They're going to have a good nade count, but no AVP able to counter that of Philo. The CT is now building up a good economy. Potentially could be holding out for a few more rounds, going into the 14th round, however. If this round doesn't go to plan for Wet Bandits, the half will be out of their control. And with a three-man push down, T4's going to have to do a lot of work here to try and counter this.
And T4 here with that controversial gun.
Yeah, picking up the SG player, last player alive for the B site. In the back, taken down by T4 for the 3k in the round.
Unfortunately,
just unscoped at the wrong moment there.
But yeah, unfortunately, the bomb is still down banana, and CT's know this. Why Cuba should really back off, but no, T4 going for the cheeky shot through the smoke, picks it up. It's now a 1v2 situation, all down to City. No head armor, doesn't need it.
Not that it's gonna make much of a difference against the AWP. Going for the ace here is T4.
Be his quiet though if he does.
Big flank. Definitely got the time for it. T4 yeah. Just gonna post to make sure he can't push. The flank is gonna be covered in there from Jay Parfit trying to steal that ace. A little bit.
I think T4's gonna be a little bit greedy. He gets taken down, it's now a 1v1 situation. Bomb is gonna be down banana. They are gonna grab it. Yeah, they've taken it. He's cut himself off, and the bomb rushes towards A. Yeah, he's going to make
the... kill the chicken.
Extra points, 1 point, mate.
I think that's only a deathmatch, but...
You know. Oh, that's actually quite... Yeah, I mean, it's quite fortunate that actually worked, and we're actually going to watch from City's perspective here as he pushes on. He's going to have to be careful here.
Pretty nice position from Jake Parker. He's not his chicken. Taken down, another round for the Wet Bandits. Potentially could make this a reasonable half at 8-7.
Yeah, I mean, even at 6 on their side, that's really good for what they've got. But yeah, they want to grab that next round so then they can make the CT side well worth it. And they're going to have to do a bit of an aggressive play, I reckon, on the CT side. At least one of B. Get that early damage in, get that information in, know where they need to rotate to. Burn Inferno, it's so easy to rotate around.
Yeah, and you can see the economical damage here coming out from the CTs, all on pharmacies. 1MP9.
Filio proving that burst mode is not the way and just takes him straight down. Two frags. He's going to pick up an AK. Jump through the smoke. Takes down his third player. Just missing out on the... City going for the team kill there. Beautiful.
Interesting. I saw a thread on Reddit about that. If you have a grenade cooked before half time and you let it go, it will automatically throw.
I can get you banned.
So you can get banned for that.
Yeah, it's pretty unfortunate.
Half-time banning you, but, you know.
I don't know if you saw in the gif of the guy doing that, though. He absolutely failed, because he's going in apartments with a grenade and trying to, like, just rush him with it held out, which is just stupid. He deserved that, I'm sorry. And it was a 7-day ban, so he's obviously done it a few times.
Yeah, clearly.
Yeah, we're going to see a bit of an A rush here from the T's, throwing a few decoys everywhere else. Otherwise, they've got mainly the armor. Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
T4 going large there.
Really nice from T4, but he's going to get traded out. And just two players now versus three.
Ooh. They're actually going to get the bomb down on site, and we're going to see this bit of a combat up in mid.
Only going to get one. Two more to deal with. And it looks like he's going to be going from apps. This one. Just going to throw a bit of flash. He's going to take out Sweet Venom Division there. And he's going to take him down with a headshot. So that's a 1v1 situation here. Cammy really has a good chance. He's going to throw a bit of a flash. Just check his behind. Let's see if he can find that last player in Cuba. If he go for the fake fuse, no. He really hasn't got much time here. He has to play this one quickly. So he's going to pull out his knife out.
I think he was deciding, you know what, I don't have time for this. I'll either go for the frag or just go for the exit. There's no way he had that. No kit. Nothing.
Yeah.
Actually, he didn't even have any armor, so there was nothing he could do.
Yeah. Bit of the flashes though.
Jay Barford being taken down to 70 HP. I think that's like the third time that's happened to him in team damage. Straight down to 48 as well.
Kill those chickens, just not paying off for him. Take out his teammate as well. Blood on that knife.
Cammy with that 5-7. It does quite a bit of damage, but. Unfortunately, just not enough. They're only taking out one player.
Oh, they're going for that. That's rotate. Means the CTs are really out of position here. They're going to have a lot of trouble rotating into this position. If Jay Con checks his position, which he does, he's going to take down T4, and that's going to be the site for them. And Sweet Lemon's just sitting in that position, trying to take out the flanker, and he is going to take out Plasmus. Last man now, Jay Parker with a deagle and armor. He definitely has potential here if he can get a few frags. But no, he's going to go down to the headshot.
Yeah, unfortunately, the accuracy of the MAC-10 whilst jumping is just crazy. it's quite impossible, quite hard to then counteract that with the deagle unless you get some ridiculous flick shot onto his head, which would have been beautiful.
Yeah, but unfortunately, not today.
They are just going to go for the full stack onto the B, potentially doing a bit of a rush down as well, I'd imagine, with one of them or two of them.
Already a bit of a disadvantage since they lost that one player, so it's going to be a full stack.
Wow.
But the information there from JPP Parfit, not going to find anything except a lot of information, and they're not going to know it's an A stake.
And he goes down anyway from Filio. That MAC-10 just proven resourceful. I mean, the money they're going to be getting for this is just crazy. So, I mean, Sweet Lemon's already on 4.76k.
Well, you say that, but Marmot left, so they can't get that much money.
That's true.
Maybe that's what he was thinking. If I'm not here, they can't get quite as much money from those eco-frags.
Playing as part of the team.
I consider it of him.
Cammy here saving the flash, which, well, to be honest, as a CT, he might as well do. I guess. This is
weird. Just looking for those exit frags. Just gonna miss that player. But perhaps. Not too bad. They're gonna be getting into the full buy here, so. Or at least JPP Pickup it is. No head armor on any of their players, but doesn't look like they're gonna need it. That's, oh, actually, Sweet Lemon staying on that MAC-10. Could definitely do a lot of damage if he was to get that instant headshot.
It's a bit weird that Jake Owen and Sweet Lemons haven't actually bought up head armor. I'd say that's really not the smartest decision against M4s.
Well, I suppose they were assuming they would be against AKs in this round. Obviously not.
Well, I'm talking from the T side, they've got two players without head armor.
Not going to matter though, as T4's going to go down to Cuba. He is going to get two kills. But neither of them headshots, so doesn't end it. That doesn't matter quite as much. This team, but definitely very low health here. This could be very doable for these CTs.
Yeah, Cammy here perfectly checking all his corners. That is what you want to be doing on Inferno. There's so many sneaky corners they can hide in. Taking out Cuba in a second, and they are going to get this defuse.
And the ramp into the CTs. No kits on the CTs, and they're gonna lose the round. Oh wow. No.
They are gonna all live, at least, but that is gonna be really unfortunate for them losing that round. I mean, they're down to 6 rounds versus Andrex, who have 13 on the T side.
I think that really was their only ticket back into this game after this. I really think they have very little hope of winning this, especially with T4 now unable to buy an M4 unless one is dropped to him. Really unfortunate there, a little blunder just costing them the round, potentially costing them a game at this stage.
He does go for the Quandi though, so this could work out quite well for them.
Well, this is the Juan Gaming League, so...
Exactly, and you know what, I'm going to keep going for the underdogs. Could always hope that they'll win this.
Well, they've still got a chance, but they are going to need to do a lot of work in this round if they want to keep themselves in this.
They have actually started this rotating. T4 in the perfect position, actually, with that deagle. He's going to get the information and get the one deagle. Oh, just misses the second. Jay Parfit proving how resourceful he can be. Listening to his team and the information turns around headshots City. Oh, 3 versus 4 situation. They've turned this out on its head. They actually have the gun advantage. Well, player advantage.
Absolutely, T4 recovering that AK-47 as well, so he can now take a bit more aggressive position. They're going to be able to put 2 men on the site now, which they haven't really been able to do yet. And 3 men on A, and just a one man trying to anchor that B site in Cammy.
They have actually rotated back towards on the A site, no one covering long, which is a bit of a body dodgy situation, but never mind. Sweet Lemons goes down to Plasmas.
Yeah, really nice kill there coming up. There's 2 players left from Andrex Sport now.
And 20 seconds on the clock. This is going very, very hard on them.
Well played, good half being called by JPP Parfit now.
He accidentally pressed the bind. Quite an interesting one considering there's no next half on this. Unless they get overtime.
Yeah, one last kill game. Secured there by QB just to put a bit of strain on that economy, but they're not going to take the round, luckily.
Wet Bandits for their 7th round, which is the first one this half. And really, this could start the snowball effect. But they are going to be playing up against the fully armed team, which are a bit late at the spawn, I'd have to say. Well, half the team anyway.
Yeah, can we just on the 5-7 here, really? Questionable decision. Definitely could have been dropped by a teammate there, but looks like he's just going to opt for that 5-7. See if he can recover a rifle by taking down one of the enemy team, as opposed to buying one himself. I'll be holding in banana, seeing if people can get that frag, get that rifle.
And we are going to see this rotation coming in back towards CT through to A. Pretty good call from CT side.
Yeah, out of the firing line there, keeping himself alive.
Oh wow. Cammy with the 5-7 going massive on the 3K there, taking them down to one player. Cuba is down to him. Luckily, he has the bomb. He's playing against three players.
Yeah, Cammy just proving us wrong. Doesn't need the rifle. Doesn't need the AK. He can do more work with the P250, and he does indeed. JPP Parfit now potentially could be rotating off the site, which could be very bad decision.
25 seconds on the clock. If he zooms in, he's just potentially given away his position there. It's quite brutal.
Only one man to deal with, though, if he can take down this one man.
He's only got 10 seconds. I think he's playing it slightly wrong. 7 seconds. He has to plant the bomb. No, he has now failed it.
Weird play there coming out from Cuba. Not going to net him much, but it is going to net the Wet Bandits one more round. Just fighting their way back into this, clawing their way back up the ladder.
Yeah, and the T-side economy, they're going to have to go for a bit of a pistol buy here. Maybe a bit of a quasi.
Yeah, and the PP Bison coming out for Philo. That is odd. Cammy just sitting in spawn for a little while, taking his time with the buy. Gonna decide to go with the AWP.
I think the sort of overconfidence coming from their side against this team was a little bit too strong. But Sweet Lemon's going massive. They're picking up T4. Well, not very massive, but definitely picking up a crucial kill there. So they're gonna be able to push through as it is smoked. They're gonna get the bomb down.
Very little armor on them, so the nades and molotovs could pay off here for the
CT. Oh wow!
Really good shot there from Cammy King, just killing that player pushing through the spike. Really point blank shot.
Jay Barfitt there, quick switch to the CC, kill on Drake Allen, and it's now a 1v3 situation. But he has an AK, gets the first kill, goes for the second, just misses his head, reloads. He had 19 bullets, still gets the first kill. Goes for the defuse. No. He's going to miss him. He knifes him.
Sweet Lemons with a knife.
That clutch.
Sweet Lemons. Oh my god.
Who hasn't picked this guy up? That was beautiful right there. Like, that was actually 4K, wasn't it? That was perfect.
My god. That was incredible. And that kill onto Cammy, that was amazing.
Yeah, that was brilliant.
I still thought he was reloading.
Obviously did a quick switch there, and I mean I did call it a bit earlier about him going massive, but he followed through and made me look, well, less stupid.
Well, so that puts it to 14-8. Have to put the Wet Bandits dream to rest, put them to sleep.
T4 opting in for throwing the weapons instead of trying to shoot him there.
JP Parker with 2 kills. Going to be named out of position there by the Molotov. Very low health on JPP Parfit. Only 6 health left. But his teammates are going to rotate in even. Batsmith with 1 kill. It isn't down to a 2v2 with 2 players low on each team.
Oh wow. J Parfit is just proving how resourceful he can be. Low HP. And they managed to clutch the round as well. And they're going to be able to pick up the AWP if they can find it.
Looks like they might even be playing with just the 3 players now. As the T4 has surrendered his weapons to the enemy.
That was quite amusing.
In the French manner, given up, given his weapons away, and decided to work for the other team. So 3 players versus 5, it seems.
And Plasma was there only with the P2000? Thought he would have even been dropped to a gun, to be honest, though. Well, at least an upgraded pistol.
I think
you
can afford a gun with 3,800.
Oh, yeah, no. That's a very weird play. Oh, and Cammy going big with that headshot on Philo.
Yeah, definitely going to open up the round. Plus, I'm just rotating, but what he can do, I'm not sure. Can I miss that shot there?
Oh, wow.
Another one. But he is going to take out the Sweet Lemons with the rifle pushing onto the site and the bomb going down on site. That's these very
I don't know if you saw that. Cammy actually.
Fake flash in the form of his pistol.
Yeah, and Cammy threw it at the back of the site as well, which is strange. Some B. These buyers, these guys are playing, it's just a bit weird. But it's actually 14-10. They've gone crazy on this. I mean, I would have thought they would have gone a lot bigger on T side, but they're proving how resourceful they can be on here with the. Yeah, it's just perfect place.
Yeah, really impressive from the Wet Bandits. Even if they aren't to win this game, at least they can say they tried. No matter what the circumstances were. They've given 100% JPPP profit in a really nice position here. Could get a few easy potential shots. He's going to get forced out of position. He's going to go for that spray down. Going to get the kill onto City, but Sweet Lemons just dropping on top of him. Going to get the kill onto him as well. So Jay Parfitt now picked himself in a really good position to take a few more heads off Cuba with the team damage. This puts them into a good position, but the bomb has gone down. The T's are from the side.
Oh, wow.
Plasmus, really nice play from him. Cuba with the P90 is the last man alive. That's breaking the smoke. He's going to get two. Is he going to get three? No, Cammy King is going to take him down, but does he have time?
He does, unfortunately, have time. Going massive, the Pro 90 there, like I said, this is a really good map for that gun. That is the 11th round for them. They are pushing really it quite tight.
Plays. Really good plays from Plasmus and JPP Parfit. Just really clawing their way back into this round. Not giving them any room to work with.
Yeah, and Jay Parfit's shot through the smoke there, the spray, picking up that kill. Quite lucky, but absolutely, very well calculated. Yeah, definitely. I mean, that is a lot of what Inferno is about, is spraying through the smoke, sort of calculating where people might be, counting the moments.
Yeah, definitely a very smoky map. Cammy going to miss his AWP shot and just going to fall back on very low health, and only 20 HP on him. And the rotation hasn't come in yet, so it'll be very bad for the CTs. Could this be when the Wet Bandits lose it?
Although they did just fail that smoke, and Cammy's going to take the first pick. Second one as well, he's going to follow up with the 3k.
One Plasmus with one. Rotate now coming in fully. Milo on the real position. DT's already done some really good work here towards the end of this game.
Yeah, and that rotation and that hold as well. I mean, the flame came in onto ramp, up onto B side, just stopped them from pushing up as well, which was completely crucial. And Cammy picking up that first two kills as well.
Really nice kills from Cammy there, even while Flash just taking down one player. And the second. Not sure if there was a third, but it was enough to secure the round.
Yeah, I really think the Andrex off there need to calculate their smokes a little bit more. I mean, they've been pushing on the sites quite well, but they really do need to push it together at the right times.
Yeah, just seeming a little bit careless at the moment, but T4 with two kills. That's going to open up the round.
Wow.
Play with that armor. Cuba will respond, but it may be a little bit too late now with only 12 HP left.
We'll rotate coming in here. I mean, they know the bomb is up in apartments, if I remember correctly. Well, Jay Parfit took him down, so they should know where the bomb is. They're going to go try and pick it up and take it back towards B. Maybe not.
They've got the bomb.
Yeah, he is retaining. Yeah,
position.
We'll push them back, yeah. Actually, Cuba down to 12 HP. I imagine he'll peak mid. There's an AK quite close to him. Oh, wait, no. Fortunately, they're going to be playing off against an AWP and a P250 in Parfit's hands. That's enough to shut them down. And it's now 14-13. This is going so well for Wet Bandits. Considering they have four players here.
I don't think anyone could have expected this scoreline. This is some really good work coming up from the four men.
Definitely not.
I think the idea from Andreyev now is just to try and get as many buy rounds as they possibly can before potentially going to overtime. Final one. They've got the AWP now, so they can oppose Cammy with his AWP.
Although Filio I'm not quite sure what he thought was going to happen there. Did he think he could actually just withstand that?
Well, I think what happened is the Molotov actually spread towards the end. So he ran through the Molotov, took a lot of damage, and then when he got to the end, it just spread a little bit, just enough to kill him. He was expecting that.
Yeah, we do have Cuba here, doing a little bit of the get right position here.
Yeah, but with a 4v4 situation, this is definitely favouring the CTs, seeing as how they've played it from the last few rounds. The main AWP are down in Philo. Tammy still watching that angle, just locking it down, making sure no one can push on him. One player up in the apps, however, he's going to get a little bit of information. If T4 can get this frag onto him, definitely his potential. He's going to see this smoke come in, and the peak.
He does land the shot, but only hits him through the wall, and a bit of team damage coming on here as well. It's a bit of bad coordination right there. They're going to be pushing long. Unfortunately, the trade-up comes from Sweet Lemons. It's more garbage, and we actually have Plasma here pushing through Library.
They're going to hear that bomb being picked up, and they're going to know something is awry at this point. With a full rotate coming in. His Plasma's going to check that corner position that he used himself.
Oh no.
Going to take down one. He's going to go for two. Both players now playing on the site. They have very little positional control. Jaycon just trying to watch that close angle. No, he's going to miss his shot. Plasma's going to get one. Plasma's going to get two. And he's going to close down the round with a 3K. Him going for the defuse. Plasma's just shutting down that round for his team.
Yeah, I mean, really, that's kind of lost when Sweet Lemons missed his shots there. I mean, he had so much time to play there. He could have just gone for the spray and taken him down, but unfortunately he waited a few seconds too long and gave the round to them. And then the positioning on site as well, the AWP up close. As soon as he missed that first shot, that's kind of a shutdown for him.
This is going to be a full buy coming up from the T's. This is their last chance. If they don't get this round, it can be going to 15 rounds for the Wet Bandits, and they could potentially take this away. A very important round there for them.
They're going to go for the full A push, and if they get these smokes off right and do the pushes, they still might get screwed over by JP Parfit with his sprays through the smoke, which he loves to do.
Yeah, and JPP Parfit just being an absolutely monumental player for his team.
Oh, definitely.
His last couple of rounds. Taking up a new position now. He's going to catch the one player going to the site. Yeah, he's gonna
what is this?
He's going to line up for him, Cuba, giving him that kill practically. Can you get the two kills?
Bomb doesn't even get down. Plasma going crazy here. Sweet Lemons is all down to you to pick up on T4. But no, he gets some backup from City. There we go. It's now a 1v2 situation. Bomb is going to go down. And we do have Cammy here with Nork coming from long. Unfortunately for him, he does get smoked off.
I'm going to try and flash its way through this, actually. Just run out of that Tech 9. We know how powerful that weapon can be, but it's not going to check them out on the site.
Wow.
So nearly got that kill, but it is going to go to 15-14. Are we going to see another overtime here?
Quite possible. I mean, they are going to have enough money on the CT side to buy full. They do need to drop a T4 here, though. And yeah, they do actually do that. T4 being able to buy the full utilities as well. They have a very strong buy. No AWPs coming in from their side. The T side, Cuba actually only going for the Galil and the smoke.
Trying to get a bit of utility, maybe that's their way in here. The frags haven't been going towards them, but the execute is what they need.
And they're going to go for this peek down banana, which is a little bit too late, I'm not going to lie, to try and pull this one off, which I think they might have noticed. We do actually have the slight rotation coming in from Plasmas here, which is a little bit early.
I'm going to be going up banana with two other players, but two players trying to sell the fake towards A. Where are they? Could that bomb potentially be going back? No, just going for the boost. Two players out here. T4 may have seen one. That is going to take him down. Nice kill there from T4. One more player in apartments. They may not be expecting this. So T4 could potentially get flanked here, but he's just going to dive into the apartments quickly enough to save his own life, but going to jump out and get taken down by City.
Bomb goes down onto B site. He's now going to be facing against two very low players. Jaycon getting taken down. This looks like it's going to be going into overtime, quite likely.
Yeah, absolutely. Really impressive work here from the CTs. I mean, who could have expected this from 14-6?
Wow.
What a half from the CT. That is really impressive work. Going to overtime. Cammy with a 32 bomb. Plasma's not too far behind with 28. JPP perfect. And T4 just rolling at the back. Really big frags from all of them.
Yeah, what can I say? This is unexpected. I mean, I think every single player on there is just doing absolutely beautifully, especially on the Wet Bandit side. They all seem to have just gelled together, been able to make the calls perfectly, and just, well, yeah, playing as a team.
I think the big question here is going to come down to their T side. Can they hold it together? Can they get those pushes in? Unless they can hold on their CT side, they won't get a chance to prove it.
Oh, definitely.
So the bomb over towards apartments. Just going to get dropped there. Gonna leave that while they go and scout out the apartment area. They know they have the man in mid. We're looking for that peek. Gonna get flashed. So there's a man close.
I mean, what I'd probably be doing in this situation is maybe chucking Cuba in as a pro 90 bait and just using him to gain that information, some quick damage as well, and basically using him as the extra man they have. Because with that on this map.
A really nice shot from Philo. Unfortunately doesn't get the kill, but it looks like Sweet Mill Lemons might take this peek and secure that. But no. He's going to lose 11 health, but he's going to get the kill nonetheless. JPPP Tarfit. He's going to get the kill on some Cuba and another JPPP Tarfit. Then we're going to get taken down. Just JPPP Tarfit and Cammy King left here.
Felio as well.
The bomb is down, however. JPPP Tarfit has control.
Oh wow.
Take that peek. Not waiting for his teammate, just trying to take the fight himself. And he's gonna get the kill as well onto Jakeon. Just Philo left now with the AWP, but we know what this man can do. He's gonna try and drop onto Jakey to half it and get taken down in that take 9.
Oh no. And he's just missed it. Cammy going in perfectly, and they pick up the first round on the overtime side.
Really close around there, you could just hear the, I'm not sure if you have the sound turned on, but JPPPP Parfit just yelling through his microphone, telling him to go, telling him not to go, telling him to go.
No, unfortunately, I have actually got that turned off, just so I don't have any sort of major sort of screaming going on. But that was an amazing play.
Some panicked voices coming from both teams here.
We actually can see Filio not realizing he still has 9k in the bank, and he has only picked up very little guns. He's trying to rush back, but he just doesn't have time. He's got 3 seconds left. One, and he cannot buy anymore.
Oh, no, he has. He's dropped it.
Oh, okay, I see. Yeah, he dropped it.
Ran out, didn't realize that he didn't have it.
I was going to say, that's a bit of a strange one right there.
Yeah. But at least he has recovered it now. So a lot of positional control now coming up. They are going to
have... Wow. Filio. He's now made that all-important play. Cammy making that flash, allowing him to back off onto B site, and JPPP Parfit actually getting taken down.
Looks like this could be the end of the fairy tale for the Wet Bandits.
Seems like they might just get wiped out by Andrex, but no, Cuba running straight into the flame.
Cammy King now the last man alive, just all the way over in that B, so he's going to have a long rotation coming in now.
And it is Cammy. But unfortunately, he's not going to have the time. He has a defuse kit, but there's no way he's going to be able to get onto the side and take them out, so he's just going to go for the exit frags and save the gun.
Yeah, definitely.
It is an AK as well. He's still going to be having quite a lot of money on the next round, which is overtime.
So yeah, the round going to be going to Wet Bandits. No exit kills going to be available for Cammy, but at least he saved his rifle. And as you can see, not too much money there on JPPPP Parfit. So potentially, towards the end of this half, he could be slightly trouble. Looks like a miss by there coming out from Plasmas, buying an AUG. Just going to leave that spawn, but now Plasmas on $850 only. So the chemical pressure being put on for sure. Especially after See, misplays like that that really don't need to happen.
No, definitely. I mean, they've just wasted a lot of economy right there, but if you can't use the AUG, then, well, yeah, you might as well just rebuy.
Yeah, not worth trying to sweat it out just because it's not your weapon.
No. I mean, if you can play it, then well played, but... And T4 going quite big there, and they managed to take down City, getting the information that they are going to be pushing towards long, and J triple P Parfit is left on A site alone down in pit.
Looks like they are going to go towards the B site. This is an interesting decision because they could have gone for one player, now they're trying to fight two.
And they have actually, they're not going to be meeting Cammy here. Well, not sorry, Cammy.
Wow. Weird positions here from the CTs.
And weird T's side, yeah, I was going to say. It's a bit of a weird one there. I mean, Sweet Lemons went and planted the bomb alone with, well, next to no defense.
Yeah, Cammy the last man now.
Yeah, and J triple P Parfit there, not realizing that he didn't get C, like he got saw.
Yeah.
Spotted. They are going to be hunting the last player, but Cammy not realizing he has no time for this. He's still going to go for the defuse. Not quite sure what he's doing here. Gets the kill on him, but loses more money in the process. It was not worth it.
Yeah, absolutely, the economical pressure being put on the CTs now. Although two of them on 10k, they can definitely afford to drop for their teammate. Only two rounds left. Hopefully going to be able to maintain that throughout the round.
Yeah, they have more than enough money. I mean, well, not for the next few rounds. I mean, if they don't win this one, it's going to be quite a tight budget for the next round.
JP Dizzle PP Parfit next round is only going to be on around 3k, so it's going to be able to drop to the FAMAS or potentially even an SMG. But one quick frag onto Cammy. Takes the lead. T4 trades that back with Sweet Lemons to put it onto a 4 versus 3 situation. Of course, going to get one bigger traded out.
Yeah, I mean, A site is now left completely alone with the two CTs sitting there on A site. This is going to leave him completely naked, and Philo taking out Plasmas. Not quite sure where J triple P Parfit is, but he's actually just left on B site. He might take down Philo here.
But no, he's going to go for that ninja play. He's eventually going to take him down, but now.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, he's going to rotate away. What a disaster. Here's the smoke goes down, so. No, it's not over yet. JP Dizzle PP Parfit, P Dog Parfit.
Oh, wow.
He's going to get one, and he knows where the last man is in the back of the site.
Not quite hearing where those shots were coming from. He is in a quite a difficult position for that orb. And he gets it anyway. That is J triple P Parfit coming into play right there, getting that clutch 1v4 situation in the end, wasn't it?
It was. 3 kills, 3 Ps. That's the Parfit for you. He takes no prisoners.
Definitely not, no. Those triple Ps, he kills them all.
Although he can't get more than a 3k. Otherwise, he'd be a 4P Parfit.
Yeah, that's just not right. Let's leave it out.
No, that's wrong.
And we're actually going to be going into, is it, if I'm right, saying the last round of this half on the overtime.
Yeah, last round of this half, yeah.
And they do get the pick down mid as well against Shade triple P Parfit. Not quite being able to use that AWP efficiently. Radio going for quite aggressive and actually taking down T4 as well, leaving two CTs to defend A site. Wow, they're just getting cleaned up.
Yeah, if only they could have done this earlier in the round, they would have had more of a chance, but...
Plasmas
does get two.
Bomb is lost on site.
Gets naded out of his position.
Apparently Kobe was seeking vengeance right there.
Fired over the 3 kill to close out the round. Not quite as big as his last game, but 24 frags on Philo. Not quite 68, but at least he's doing
best. I mean, compared to what he was doing on the T side originally, he's doing very well now. Well, on the CT side, rather, he's doing very poorly. BS brought his game back up and is helping to push his team into victory, potentially.
Absolutely, and I think this round here could be the true test. Are Wet Bandits able to get it together for their T side, or is this just going to fall apart now?
Yeah, we are going to see the three AKs and one AWP on the T side. And it's actually stacked towards B, so this is going to work in their favour as they push through. Unfortunately, Jaycon failing there with the shots. J triple B perfect, taking out the Sweet Lemons. Going absolutely crazy here, taking no prisoners.
So far, this T side looking quite strong. Few men coming from construction, and another one hoping to join them soon. JPP Parfit just gonna flush himself through, and he may get the two frags here, and he does. He takes down two CTs, leaving it in a 1v4 situation, and Plasmus will close it out on the city.
And J triple P Parfit proving that he can only get those 3Ks, and that is fine, because that is who he is.
That's
Parfit. That was a beautiful round for them. They absolutely cleaned them up there, taking no prisoners, like I was saying, keep saying, but they are just playing beautifully. I mean, they've got four players, but on the T side, they are able to push a lot more aggressive on that.
Are we going to another overtime?
If we do, it's going to be mental. If we go into three overtimes, I don't know what to say.
They wow.
Really are. That perfect flick shot up onto his head.
And definitely more for him to find after the motion of Caesar to push onto his position. Wow. And T4 with one kill into the apartment. It's a really nice flick there. Thanks, sitting you down. On to bed.
And he'll be sleeping with the fishes now, pushing up some of the daisies. So yeah, 3 versus 4, and I mean, still it's quite favourable for the T side.
Yeah, absolutely. They,
and Cuba getting flashed as well.
Takes one down and is traded himself. Cooper in the pit takes down one, leaving just Cammy alone with the bomb to try and clutch out this round.
If he does this rotate, he could do it very well. He's got 38 seconds to rotate towards B, and he is just going to rush for it.
Does the fake nicely, however. Throws in that nade. The CTs are all going to be on the site, but JQon has figured it out. He's rotating back. Potentially quick enough, he's going to see the smoke going down, and that is going to be the tell that they needed to see.
Cammy here going for the frag on JQon, and this is going to open it up for him if he can get this bomb down in time, which he can, and then take up position. Which he is throwing down the flame. Enough time to reload, but he's going to put himself in a bit of a dangerous position as the smoke goes away and gets picked off by Cuba.
That through the smoke?
No, that was as it was fading.
Oh, I was going to say that would have been a really nice play there from Cuba. Still a really nice play. Just not nice enough. JQon there in chat wasn't expecting that as Cammy just pushes through the smoke and attacks.
Yeah, that was really well read by Cammy.
Yeah, but unfortunately, just not quite the right circumstances, and he isn't able to close out that round. Perhaps another day, Cammy. Perhaps another day.
Yeah, we're coming up into the last two rounds on here, and Philo taking down T4. That is such a crucial kill for them.
Yeah, this could potentially be the closer now if Philo's able to keep up this form. He has got all the way down mid, he knows where the T's are. They call him for the rotation, but he's going to stick to the sights, stick to what they know, and going to try and fight off the T's as they come to them. Looks like the execute now coming onto the B site. Flank wherever coming in. Plasmus is going to take out one, and he's going to double back and go for the double flank. Nice work there, but he's going to get taken out by Cuba.
Yeah, he's going to that M4A1 there. Quite quickly.
And triple P Parfit is going to be the last man to go down.
And he actually gets the kill with the deagle. It seems like potentially the last round here, unless Webband is going to bring it back. They are going to go for that negative buy. I think Cammy accidentally bought that. Throws it away quite
at this
quickly.
Point, I don't think it matters, but unfortunately for us, they are not going to hang on to that negative, and instead just going to go with those AK-47s and triple P Parfit on the AWP. Going to try and get that pick down mid, see if Philo's going to be audacious enough. No, it's going to be City instead, but he's still going to miss that shot, thanks to his teammate just shoulder peeking in front of him.
That can always be quite an issue if someone down mid is blocking your sight, then it can be really distracting. They're actually going to make it towards long as well. They're going to be facing off against JQon here in library. Soon to be Cuba as well. JQon taking down T4. It's now 3 versus 5 situation. Cammy taking down City just in time. Bomb just making out in sight in time. But they are going to be playing up against Philo. Bomb goes down. 2 versus 3 situation.
Philo just going to catch that man trying to get around the back with the bomb. Leaving just Plasmas left now. The game in his hands. Versus Philo. He's going to take down Philo at least. So he is still in this. He has the bomb. He can go towards B. Trying to keep him in this game. Can be calling GG. Maybe too early here. Philo definitely. Plasmas even definitely has a chance here. Sweet Lemons and Cuba are going to be the men trying to take him down. There's only 20 seconds left. Has the sight. He's one man. Very little he can do at this point.
Yeah, he is going to be playing quite hard against him. He's going to be facing a field and an AK in quite a tough situation. It takes down the first player. It's now 1v1 situation. This is quite crucial. 29 HP. Flash out the ready. Switches back to his gun. They know where he is. The spray guns in and he goes down. And that is the game. Andrex Soft finishing up wet bandits, wiping them out of the league.
The wet bandits are now dry as the Andrex has wiped them off the face of this earth. GGs are called.
No, and that was such a beautiful game to watch. I mean, they're playing with just four people and they played it so well. And I mean, the kills across the board on both teams are quite equal as well.
Should we speak to what remains of the wet bandits?
Let's go for it.
User joined your channel.
Guys. Hello.
How you doing?
Hello.
That was amazing.
I can't believe you put that out of time.
Yeah, that was beautiful to watch.
Day triple P perfect, so close. Yeah, so far.
I think just after CV side, we were just done, like, overtime.
Yeah, no, it can be pretty much of a killer, especially when you're playing a 4v5, and you're playing so well as well, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, that's a bit of...
I think I had before fire frags before overtime, and then I just... Oh, well.
I'd say you're all MVPs of that game. That's crazy.
Right. Yeah.
I mean, it's obviously...
So what happened to your player?
Oh, he sounded very drunk, and then started flaming everyone, so we just got him... And he just left the team sweep. And he kept spamming us and everything, so...
Yeah, and I did see, obviously, in spawn, he was blocking you a few times, which was really disappointing as well. I mean, you just don't want to see
it. I'm a very angry person at times, so obviously keeping him around when he's been a twat wouldn't really help at all, so...
No, yeah, and I mean, to be honest, it seemed like you guys gelled together really well after you got rid of him.
I mean... I'm surprised the 4v5 made it work. I mean, we got about... when did I 1v3? I think I was on CC.
Yeah, that was crazy.
Whatever, yeah. And it was just about him just shouting in the team suite. It was quite nice, to be honest.
Yeah, and I mean, I don't know, if you rewatch it as well, it's going to be quite funny.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to rewatch it.
just with your name and stuff, because obviously sort of J Parfit and stuff, we were like J Triple B Parfit and stuff, and the fact that you are only picking up 3Ks, no more. And we're just making a reference to that the whole time, it's quite funny. No more, no less. But you know, it was really fun to watch. It's a shame that you lost
great.
Your fifth.
It's fun to play as well.
No, yeah, definitely. Yeah. And obviously it's a bit of a casual, but...
Yeah, exactly.
I think you should find a fifth and potentially look for team guys.
Cause yeah, I'd love to find awesome. Like a decent team to go and see.
Yeah, I mean, there's a pre-made next week, and it seemed like you guys had pretty good synergy. From your side, what do you think of each other?
Well... I reckon me, Clammy and Plaz, I'd go. So the other guy, camera's name.
E4.
User joined your channel.
He did get a bit salty towards the end. Like, he started flaming, but I don't know. I think he's just tired of mix of that.
Yeah. I think he was wanting to go. Yeah. And I mean, he is reaching towards the time. Yeah, it was like 1 minute before he wanted to go out. So,
yeah, it was 12.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't expect it to go on this too long, but it's always good. I mean, overtime is fun to watch. It can be tiresome, especially on a Friday night after work and stuff.
Pretty much.
I'm actually gonna go now, so.
So, mate, thanks for taking part, guys, and I'll see you up next time.
It was fun.
Right,
fun.
Harold, let's go in the next one.
User left your channel.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Yeah.
How'd you feel?
Well, there was four of them, so, you know.
Yeah, they played very well.
Yeah, they did.
That was a hard game.
No, yeah, and I mean, you play very well towards the end there as well, I mean, during as well. They seem to gel very well together after they got rid of the, rotten part of the team, to be honest.
Yeah, they did a good one.
No, yeah, but you mean...
It was a pretty good game.
Yeah, you managed to go great at it as well. Really there, yeah. Saw you weren't doing so good on the CT side at first, but you did bring it back, though.
Yeah. I gave him too much respect at the start. No, but yeah. And I just, fuck it, just get your load.
Exactly.
No, yeah, it's a really enjoyable game to watch. Both teams very respectable, so.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes. Can I make £50,000, please?
Did we get £50 and summer's voucher?
Yeah.
I may already get my mum.
Jake wants a £50 summer and summer's voucher for his mum.
No, I don't. What are you on about?
Mate, she's got enough stuff from there already.
Oh, wow, there's like 12 people watching, thank you.
Wow. 15, mate, 15.
Oh, okay, hi, 15 people.
Well, fine, we'll set him at £15 voucher then, shall we?
You're famous.
Enough for a dildo.
Do we have to share this voucher?
Not a dildo, I hope.
Oh, God. And things just turned... Last family show, guys, family show.
Yeah, keep it clean.
I have to give you a family bucket from...
Wipe it with some Andrex, keep it clean.
that was quite funny. I don't know if you guys knew, but basically I called it from the beginning. I wanted you guys to be playing against Wet Bandits, because obviously Andrex versus wiping up the Wet Bandits was quite funny.
Yeah.
But you said the Wet Bandits were going to wipe the floor with us.
Yeah, well, if they had their proper fifth player, then I don't know, we might be in a different game.
Chance,
yeah,
no chance. I think they would.
No, then we would have upped our game. We going easy on them.
I mean, you went into overtime the game before, so you, to be honest, you must have been a bit exhausted from that as well.
Yeah, that's my excuse. Yes. I was tired.
Any excuse works, right?
Exhausted.
Yeah. No, yeah. It was quiet, so I was thinking, went to like 3 overtimes or something, 2 overtimes, sorry.
Yeah, and I mean that's...
Nearly 4 rounds as well, nearly 50 rounds.
Yeah, well I mean, just taking into consideration, it's good practice if you want to go further in CSGO. And I mean, if the pre-made tournaments, it's one of the reasons why we don't have the best of 3 on every game, and why we don't have best of 3 in the mixed one as well. Sometimes, like, I think the latest the pre-made finish is maybe 1:30, maybe 2, which is just ridiculous.
Damn.
Yeah.
Damn.
So it's like sort of testing your, stamina, to be honest.
Yeah,
but...
the beer ones are fair anyway.
Yeah.
The vetoes and stuff.
No, yeah. It's really good.
I think I was doing better towards the end.
you did really well, sweetie. I mean, you managed a clutch, I think.
That knife was
really
nice.
That was the luckiest clutch ever.
you were reloading. I don't know.
Reloaded. Fucking just one tapping while jumping in the air. I was just there like, that's so lucky.
Yeah, Jake. Yeah, when you really jumped around the corner, I was like, oh, he's going massive. He was like, why did I say that? He killed one person and then you cleaned it up with a clutch. So I was like, yeah, thank fuck for that.
Yeah, the B doors really worked for me. One B.
Yeah.
Right. Anyway, thank you very much, guys, for watching and playing.
Thank you very much for putting it on, dude.
Yeah,
no problem. Absolute joy.
Once again.
So yeah, hope you'll be able to get some rest now this weekend, and you can start practicing and try and find a team.
Yeah.
Cheers,
congratulations.